Does our karma in some ways predispose us to allowing Amida Buddha to bring that faith up and forward to us?
Yes, it's what we discussed last time about the good from the past, which is one of the five conditions to be born in the Pure Land. So this, but it's a karma related to our devotion to various Buddhas. You see? So yes, past karma can make you be more open. Can put you in a receptive state of mind towards Amida Buddha's primal vow. But that karma was created by you by being devotional towards various Buddhas, by treating teachers with respect, by treating the Dharma with respect. So those things that you did in terms of respect and devotion towards the various Buddhas and the Dharma can manifest, will manifest sooner or later in an open state of mind towards the Buddha Dharma in general and towards Amida Buddha himself. And especially if you made offerings to various Buddhas out of devotion, that will create an open state of mind. That's why also we advise people who don't have faith yet in Amida Buddha to at least have a devotional and respectful attitude towards Buddhism in general and towards various Buddhas, and even towards Amida. We encourage people, even if they don't have faith, to make offerings to Amida Buddha, to make bows to Sei Nembutsu, even if they don't have faith yet, to constantly listen to the Dharma and ask questions. Because all of this will sooner or later put you in an open state of mind. All these are good from the past. By good from the past, we mean actions like those described recently that you did in other life, but also in this life prior to awakening to faith. See? So to be respectful and devotional towards Buddhas and the Dharma and Amida, that is creating
Yes,
a karmic openness.
I really
Yes.
hope that maybe Joshua Sensei in the video puts the link to the listening deeply
Yes.
to the Dharma. It's a very good article there. There are 12
Some
recommendations there.
elements. I have an article. Some elements of listening deeply
Yes.
to Amida Dharma, in order to receive Shinjin.
It's a very good
Very
article.
simple explanations. Yes.
Yes, normally when people ha ask me this question, I always go send them straight to that article because it's very simple and very very bullet points by boom 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 of how to what to do in order to receive faith. It's a very good article. Yes.
When somebody asks me, what should I do in order to listen deeply to Amida Dharma? Please give me some examples of listening deeply. And I said, think that solving the matter of repeated births and deaths is the most important thing in your life. And then put aside all other Buddhist or non-Buddhist teachings, philosophies, and opinions, and listen. Reading is also listening. Only to Amida Dharma. Put aside what you think you know and listen to what Amida Dharma has to say. Empty your cup or your mind of your so-called personal wisdom and stay open to receive the nectar of Dharma. Consider that you know nothing and that Amida Dharma knows everything. That's something that modern scholars don't do. They think they know everything. They are smart. They are smarter than the Dharma. That's why they have the cup filled with their so-called wisdom, and they can't receive the Dharma because they don't have devotion to the Dharma. Also, another element of listening deeply: read the most simple and essential texts of our school. Next, listen with a devotional mind and heart. Listen again and again. Constantly in the manner described above. Ask questions if you have doubts or if there is something you don't understand. Study the answers carefully and without hurry. and ask again if you need to. That's why the teachers and priests of Amidaji have to always be available. That's why if you saw Gregory, whenever you ask me something, I try my best to answer quickly. It's important. Okay. Engage in a Dharma dialogue, not debates. Because debates means that you think you are smarter than the Dharma. The Dharma is not debatable. Engage in a Dharma dialogue with people who are already established in faith and who do not embrace wrong views. It's important to not go to various online groups where there is no strict moderation and where everybody says whatever they want. That's doctrinal chaos. So avoid places of doctrinal chaos. No? Think of the testimony of Shakyamuni Buddha himself and of so many wonderful masters like Nagarjuna, Vasubandhu, Shantao, Honen, Shinran, Renyo, who accepted the existence of Amida Buddha and the reality of his salvation. Always ask Amida Buddha for guidance, bow to him, and say his name, even if you are not yet established in faith. No matter how many doubts you have or how awkward it might be at the beginning, find some time to sit with Amida Buddha and ask him for guidance. Give a chance to the idea that Amida Buddha and his salvation are real. I also said in that article, you really have nothing to lose if you accept Amida's salvation. So think to this. You have nothing to lose if you accept Amida's salvation. On the contrary, you gain everything. You will be born in the Pure Land at the end of your life and become a Buddha. Your suffering in the repeated births and deaths will be over and you will be capable of truly helping others, especially your dear ones. Please also meditate on what you have to lose if you do not accept the existence of Amida Buddha and the reality of his salvation. The chance you now have to be in human body and listen to Amida Dharma might not be met in thousands and thousands of lives, because it's very rare to be born a human being. And not only a human being, but a human being with the capacities to listen the Dharma and understand the Dharma, and to be a human being who have met the larger sutra and entrusted to the larger sutra into the primal vow. So just give it a try and do the above things in this list for some time. Also, use the days you will stay at Amidaji, if you come to Amidaji, or if you attend meetings for this, to fulfill these elements. So that's it.
Yes. Thank you, Sensei. Yes, those are the 12 elements are indeed very, very important. I always...
don't know if they're 12. 12.
Mm. 12 in total, yes. I count them. I always give these elements and I sometimes read them out loud to people who have questions about how to become open or how to read Amida Dharma. It's very important to be devotional, but there are many aspects to it. So you have to follow each one of them. I think they're very useful.
And yes, very important is to keep focus on Amida Buddha Dharma. Keep focus on this. Don't go to various places. Don't wander here and there. Don't go to people who don't have faith. Don't go to Facebook pages, groups, and where everybody says whatever they want. Don't get close to modernists who deny the existence of Amida Buddha. Choose good spiritual friends. That's the advice of Shakyamuni Buddha. Shakyamuni Buddha didn't say that we should be open to be friends with everybody when we are unenlightened. We can be friends with the people who follow wrong views after we become Buddhas in the Pure Land of Amida. But at the level we are now, when we need to learn and to be established in faith and to reach the Pure Land, we need to have good spiritual friends and avoid bad spiritual friends. Those who deny the existence of Amida, of Shakyam, of the Pure Land, and who don't have faith. And surround ourselves with good teachers and good practitioners of faith. Yes.